Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. The Gospel passage for our meditation is taken from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 11, verses 37 to 41. While he was speaking, a Pharisee asked him to dine with him, so he went in and sat at table. The Pharisee was astonished to see that he did not first wash before dinner. And the Lord said to him, Now you Pharisees cleanse the outside of the cup and of the dish, but inside you are full of extortion and wickedness. You fools, did not he who made the outside make the inside also? But give for alms those things which are within, and behold, everything is clean for you. The Gospel of the Lord. Does your exterior reflect your interior? To what extent we are integrated persons? Do we walk the talk? We all have two realities that make our life, the internal and external realities. Often we are attracted to things by its appearance. We may fail to see the quality, so finally we are cheated. When we see the things are not serving our purpose. A sincere person tries to reflect the interior through his daily behavior. To what extent we can welcome Jesus to our interior, and will he find our heart a worthy place to stay? In today's gospel, we hear how a Pharisee was moved to invite Jesus to home after hearing the merciful words of Jesus. It was not unusual for a rabbi to give a teaching over dinner. Jesus, however, did something which offended his host. He did not perform the ceremonial washing of hands before beginning the meal. Did Jesus forget, or was he deliberately performing a sign to reveal something to his host? Yes, Jesus used the table fellowship to teach people to know about the need of interior purity more than exterior elegancy. Have you ever thought what can make our life impure and how we can make the heart clean and holy? Think for ourselves, which is more important to God, clean hands or a clean mind and heart? Jesus chided the Pharisees for harboring evil thoughts that make us unclean spiritually, such as greed, pride, bitterness, envy, arrogance, and the like. Why does he urge them and us to give alms? When we give freely and generously to those in need, we express love, compassion, kindness, and mercy. And if the heart is full of love and compassion, then there is no room for envy, greed, bitterness, and the like. Do you allow God's love to transform your heart, mind, and actions toward our neighbor? In the first book of Samuel, chapter 16, verse 7, we read, But the Lord said to Samuel, Eliab is tall and handsome, but do not judge by things like that. God doesn't look at what people see. People judge by what is on the outside, but the Lord looks at the heart. Eliab is not the right man. Samuel had confusion to anoint which of Jesse's sons be anointed as the new king of Israel. God directed Samuel not to judge by appearance, but by interior disposition. Many of the relationships are based on the appearance, and there is no touch of sincerity into it. The interior is seen by only you and your God, but your exterior is open to everyone. We may hide our real identity by pretending to be someone different, but time will prove our real identity. We cannot hide our interior from God, since He is our Creator. A sincere person does not keep double-mindedness with him. He always looks for what is best for the people and for God. Keep his hands pure as well as his heart. Do you keep your hands pure as well as your heart? And I pray, may Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.